While appearing before the Parliamentary Committee of Budget to defend the budgetary allocations for the Ministry of Health, the chairperson of the Health Committee of Parliament, Dr. Charles Ayume, recommended the Budget Committee to reallocate 319 billion for Lwowa International Specialized Hospital into improving lower level health facilities, especially health center falls.
I think any spare money we have right now, as the chairperson of the sector, I think should be put in health center falls. And some of the dilapidated health center falls and the hospitals that I had mentioned, and also the regional referral hospitals.
Ayume told the committee that the last time the health committee visited Lwowa, they were disappointed with what they found on ground, with the site stalled at the foundation level.
The committee had visited Lwowa Hospital in November 2021 and did not find progress. The committee visited the site in 2021, and this time were given access, and we actually found a site at foundation level, and there was no evidence that there had been recent construction. It seemed to be for lack of a better word, stagnated.
The Health Committee of Parliament also wants government to halt construction of new hospitals and concentrate the available resources on equipping, rehabilitating and resourcing the available dilapidated hospitals and health center falls. A proposal that has been supported overwhelmingly by the Budget Committee.
The government policy should now focus on the existing health care facilities, most specifically the health center for. Health Center 4 is an opportune, case, because first and foremost, they all have theaters. And with the theater, we now have a leverage to save life. A life due to accident that we should have lost, a life that we should have lost due to maybe a mother giving birth.
It's a consumptive budget. 80% goes to recurrent expenditure and it's only 20% on development. That means you cannot do much. Automatically, if you can't do much, then do the basic. Look at health center 4s, health center 3s, equip them. Put medicines there, ultrasound scans, such that mothers don't just die anyhow. Two, we look at the issue of land under those districts that have no land. For example, Sembabule, all the health center 3s and health center 4s don't own titles, and the government has left this responsibility to local governments that no longer have local revenue.
The Ministry of Health seeks 368 billion to construct 135 health center 3s and 51 billion to upgrade 30 health center falls, and 11.8 billion for rehabilitation of Soroti Hospital, which has not been funded in the next financial year budget. Budget committee members have protested another request for 625 billion by the Ministry of Health to mitigate the anticipated resurgence of COVID-19 in the future.
Our colleagues were not yet out of the woods. COVID is still with us. And as a sector, we anticipate that we may have another wave in future, so we want to take the vaccination down to between 9 to 18 years old. And the vaccines that are to be procured are Pfizer, because they're the only ones that work best within children.
Most of the vaccines that have come to Uganda have come by way of donation, but these fellows are putting 600 billion shilling in the budget. I fear they may, in a very short time, announce a new wave and raise it supplementary, because it becomes the easiest way of blackmailing Parliament and the country. So don't be surprised if you hear around July that a new wave has hit us. We need a supplementary budget.
They need a budget for COVID-19 in preparation of a new wave that we do not even know about. There is no science across the world that has proved beyond reasonable doubt that we're going to have another wave of COVID-19.
Does the wave bounce back more than three times? So we shall need all that. That's why we shall need the technical team to give us all that. But we don't want to draw conclusions now.
The health committee has also called on MPs to stop buying fake ambulances and instead approve the allocation of 5.6 billion required by the Ministry of Health to fund the establishment of the National Ambulance Service System.
We have a national ambulance policy, which actually now spells out the type of ambulances to be bought. So what we would be buying as members of parliament do not qualify to transport patients. They actually just transport vehicles.
This report was compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.